gentlemen, please welcome our next speaker, Mr. Pramod Sadarjoshi, Senior Director, Oracle India Private Limited.
I would like to call upon Dr. G. Gopalakrishnan, Director, BIMHRD, to welcome Mr. Pramod Sadarjoshi with a bouquet. Thank you, sir. May we now call upon Ms. Dhara Soni, Student Manager, Balaji Institute of Management and Human Resource Development, to introduce Mr. Pramod Sadarjoshi.
Good morning, everyone. It gives me immense pleasure and honor to welcome our guest, Mr. Pramod Sadarjoshi, Senior Director, HCM Strategy and Transformation, Asia Pacific, Oracle India Private Limited. Sir has done his MBA in HR from this moment. Sir is gold medalist at graduation in math and psychology. Sir is empaneled executive coach at the prestigious ISB Hyderabad and has also coached approximately 35 CEO and 250 CXO level executive. Sir has contributed towards the industry academy synergy by being teaching faculty member and advisor at IIM, IIT and other premium institutions. Sir has stellar work experience spanning across sector. He has been worked for many renowned companies. He was director in HR, Microsoft Corporation, director in HR, Computer Science Corporation. Sir, we are deeply honored to welcome you. I request you to address and encourage student manager.
Morning, everybody.
Morning, sir.
Wow, love the energy. I think I met some of you last year.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Hi.
Hi, sir.
Wonderful. I don't know why you call me, but I come here to get myself energized by this awesome, awesome crowd. Give a big hand. Being here, I was just talking to professor. I believe this batch is the first year batch.
Yes, yes sir.
See you next year again.
Yes, sir.
This is the final year batch.
Yes, sir.
And that also the final year batch.
Yes, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen, They are called God's Gift to Mankind, MBAs. All right? They are solutions for everything. I don't know what you guys are talking about. Okay. Do you have a cello tape? You can just show. Okay. I'm meditating. Okay? Are we good? Happens to the oldest state. Technology is a great slave, but a very bad master. So it just follows that technology under your control. So I'm going to be doing something very different this year because invariably every year I come here and I would ask them how much time do I have. Before they can respond, Bala sir would say no time limit continue, you know, which is nice. But I want to make this time a very now what? I put stuff out there. You guys must have now been bored of PPTs. I believe I'm the 11th speaker, is that right? 7 yesterday, about 3 this morning. So I'm not going to bore you with it. And there's no genius in me doing our data and presenting. Some perspective is important. But I think I really want to make this very value-added. I'm not going to be talking about it. I will not abuse this platform by boasting about myself or my company. That's not the context. I think the context is really, I've been through this journey. Can I be of some help to you? Are there some problems in your mind? Are there some demons really, really harassing you in your mind? What is it in 6 months from now, placements will start? The first year people have come with dreams. I mean, every seat here, can you even begin to imagine how lucky you are with God's grace? If you made it here, think of that poorer cousin of yours who's not in this Balaji hall, but was doing M.Com in college. He missed it probably by a whisker of an admission to Balaji. And therefore, just be very humble about it. So, no talk on Oracle, no preaching. I'm still a student of the game. I'm still learning. And actually, this is an amazing digital millennial crowd. So I need to learn a lot from you people. All right? I'm only going to be propounding some themes and actually make it a lot more participative. There are no stupid questions. I could probably give a stupid answer. So do not feel shy, afraid, inhibited in asking what's really bothering you. What's going on here? What's really going on? Is what I wanted to table it here. As much as time permits, we'll address them. So that at the end of it, it's a good, solid business session where there's a mutual respect, where there's value addition, and you go on saying, I cracked it. So with that, is the screen up here? Yeah. So, you know, I first thought I'd give it a title called Designing Destiny. Then I said, oh, destiny is God. I can't design it. Then I thought, decoding, re-architecting self. I said, let me share with this crowd, how does script, like a film writer, today, you know, writers are in demand. When a movie like Damnaga ke Haisha makes a story, there's a writer there, some medical Jew who did phenomenal scripting. So how does script your life? Only one reason, this is the most beautiful moment of your life. You're in the prime of your youth, energy is bubbling, amazing opportunities, you're going to look at it, some data, amazing stuff. I wish I was in this generation. Sometimes I don't wish. Because, oh my God, the number of channels you need to deal with, the number of data points that's coming in, hats off to your ability of your CPU to process data, sift it, and yet come up with amazing decision-making process. So hats off to you people. All right? Okay, they already introduced this, so I'll just skip this. But I'm very lucky to work for some really great organizations. And everywhere, I learned a lot. Today, if I'm what I am, a lot of it goes to that kind of an organization that I work for. They give me a certain rigor and a discipline, and I'm absolutely the humbler guy thanks to this organization. Okay, very simple, ladies and gentlemen, my flow is very simple. Just three bullets. What's your current context? I'm going to give some scenarios. All of you already know some of it, so just give the context and see how it pans out. Number two, physics student, there's a word called vector, disha. What's the vector shaping up? What's your vector? What's your vector? Do you even have a vector?
Yes, sir.
I was talking to two students who were accompanying me, and amidst plethora of opportunities and the demigod peer pressure, life is hell sometimes. You don't know how do you pick that finger and put on the pulse. What is my inner calling? Marketing, finance, entrepreneurship, go back to farming, put up an FMCG store, what is it? And each one of you has got a DNA which is specific, with its amazing competencies and some inadequacies. How do you kill the inadequacies, highlight the competencies, so that you emerge as a super, super successful, holistically successful guy, not just owning a Merck or a BM5 or a APNC or apartment. Really, are you a person who carries this amazing energy? Where you can come in and you say, this is me, and I'm going to be adding value to my contract. And finally, I'll give an architecture. And it's a very interesting word I've used because I'm not just going to use some systemic frameworks. I'm actually going to touch that aspect of your build-up, which is going to be throughout your lifetime. Okay? All of it has born from my experience. Some Google drop-down data, but a lot of it is solid experiential facilitation. Alright? Okay. Okay. I guess you must have seen this.
Yes.
This is going viral all over the place. And why I said sometimes I'm afraid to belong to this generation. You work in that background. I mean 2 million Google searches. I mean 2.7 million video views in 60 seconds. I mean 28.8 million messages on WhatsApp. I mean WhatsApp got sold for $19 billion to Facebook. WhatsApp is not a cancer-saving drug. In fact, maybe it's a cancer industry, right? With all the tick-tick-tick that goes on. In that backdrop, you people, I salute you. Because for your mind to be so clear, uncluttered, to make swift decisions, hats off. I'm in that generation too. I live in that backdrop. Extremely critical for you to know what is happening out there and how do you deal with this. The reason I talked about this is the whole digital world that you're working under. This is the external world. Okay, let me ask, any doctors here? Anybody who's done MBBS? How many? Okay, because when I used to teach at IIM Ahmedabad and Bajaj, I did have MBBS students coming in for MBA, so I just thought. The reason I asked is, does anybody know how many organs are there in a body? Okay, I just did some homework. There are 78 organs in the body. And ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to introduce you to the 79th organ of the body. What's that? Last minute before I go to bed, I pray, just before I close my eyes, one little. I get up at 4:35 in the morning. First thing is, before I pray God, any mail from the boss. If this is not ordered, what else is, right? Your bank is here, your salary is here, your PowerPoints are here. And now with iPhone 7 and many more multi technology coming in, your life is going to be extremely complex. So with that, what I'm trying to say is, you've got to be really quick on the go. So I'm an executive coach of the Indian School of Business, right? Last 14 years I've been coaching CEOs and CXOs. One of the new competencies we have introduced to evaluate a CEO is on an amazing competency called on-the-go decision-making. You get out from an aircraft, you see when a plane comes too hot, when the air hostess says, you all can now use a mobile phone, everybody is up there, you know, as a life is depending on this. And you need to take some quick decisions, which was not the case 20 years back. So the kind of pace with which you need to have, and most important, the sheer physical tenacity and stamina is extremely critical. We talked about this, it is still not gone away. This is nothing but VUCA, and I think you don't know about this. You all know about this?
Yes, sir. Okay.
People have beaten this team to their death, but I do not know how many speakers here have given a strategy to attack. Does anybody have a strategy on attacking VUCA? Right. Everybody comes and performs a theory. So I was presenting at a seminar and I said, look, how about solution architecture? Oh no, propounding themes is all fine, but how do you do solution architecture? So ladies and gentlemen, if you are a victim of volatility, the way you want to counter that is one simple word, have a vision. The moment a vector is defined, volatilities are managed. I'll give you an example. If I'm the head of training, and I say three of these ladies and two of these people will go and attend a program at Harvard Business School or at Lausanne, then whether the profitability next year is there or not, I have budgeted for it. So there are two things. One is a vision, and second is execution of that strategy. So that's how you're dealing with volatility. Unpredictability. How many engineers here? There you go. These people are known to be relatively superior at data crunching, the quant stuff. Unpredictability has to be countered with the discipline of data science. Today there are positions for data ecologists in a company. The whole field of predictive and prescriptive analytics is a sure shot counterforce to unpredictability. How do you deal with complexity? A quick solution. Complexity is when you take a huge project all at once. Instead, if you can do what they call the WBS, the work breakdown schedule, split it into modules, and come up with two other things, A, plan B, and most important, should that fail, then what is your contingency? Once you do that, what you insure yourself against is a good security against any kind of complexity. And lastly, ambiguity, I'm going to be touching upon it to the later part of the presentation, extremely critical to be very, very, very transparent in your dealings. You see what you get what you see. There's no game playing. There is no lack of transparency. It's complete transparency. That's how you deal with it, all right? And therefore, look at some of the disruption that VUCA has caused. The next slide, very interesting slide, all right? Those are the disruptions, ladies and gentlemen. The owner of Uber does not own a single taxi. Right? So, world's largest taxi company owns no taxis. And Mr. Tavistock was stuck in Paris, the birth of Uber. He wanted a cab, he didn't get a cab. And Uber was born. And today it's almost called, Uber has become a word, they say Uberization. What does that mean? So you order a Uber or whatever you call it, and then, next time you want to order it, first thing is you need to pay the money. As soon as you click the money, it gives you 5-star ratings. What's happening? In exactly 30 seconds, you are making performance appraisal of the driver. If that guy gets 3 times below 3 score, he's hauled up for whatever, bad smell in the car, rough driving, did not know the rules. Look what's happening. And this is done by each and everybody. Largest accommodation provider, Airbnb. Last year I was in Europe, I stayed in all the Airbnb places. And we have our own homegrown Airbnb. The gentleman used to sell SIM cards in Lajpat Nagar market in Delhi. And one day he gets an idea. In each of your homes, if you ask your parents, There will be one room which is relatively less used. He aggregated those rooms and started OYO rooms. He got $135 million funding from Mr. Nikesh Arora of Bank of then. Why this disruptiveness will happen? Look at the other ones. Largest phone company is Skype. Most popular video on Earth creates no content. Facebook. It's the biggest popular. 2.78 million videos every second. Sorry, every minute. How dangerously intimidating is that kind of a data? Largest movie house, Netflix. They do not own theaters. The largest software vendors, they do not write the apps. Apple and Google. All right? You guys write the apps. And therefore, startup is all about rewarding people who write such apps. In Bombay, there's an app called M Indicator. Anything and everything about Mumbai transport is up there. One engineer like you, one smart guy saying, set up an open way, I'll do something. All right? So that's disruption that's happening. Better rise up, shake hands with this intimidating tsunami or the digital tsunami. And the more easy way you sort of shake hands, better will be your life. All right. You've seen this picture last year also. I love this. Well, this is a lovely Sunday beach for first year students. So do not get any wrong ideas. A gentleman by the name Warren Buffett has a very different take on this picture. But you and I get excited. And his take is as follows. You get to know who's been swimming naked only when the tide goes down. Warren Buffett. What does that mean? Well, things are going great. There's a swagger in your walk. There's a crying in your talk. You're all this great confidence. But one tsunami, one VUCA, one bad behavior, one accident, does it shake you up? And ladies and gentlemen, I don't want to be preaching, you will have a lot of rocky path in your life. I think the guys who succeed in this batch are guys who are going to take the rough with equanimity and poise and preparation. When things are going up, good for you, you will shine. But I think the star emerges when you really hit the sine curve, the crest of a sine curve, you know? The bottom one. And that's what is very, very critical. So what's the ecosystem? This is very important. Each one of you is sitting in one of these boxes at any point in time. See, there is an external world and there's an internal world. So there are four quadrants. So individual, internal. I'll tell you, a lot of you guys in the jobs are going to get questioned on values. The last thing you want is you appearing in Economic Times front page in bad news. Nobody will be more hurt than your parents who invested this money. I'm not trying to be moralistic here, but you've got to be brutally, brutally transparent and ethical. That whole game there, a lot of people who are playing bad games, I won't take names here, but professional ethics do not allow me to take the names. Those are people who stood up on that for the first quarter. Because, you know, the intoxication of success, the headiness of all glamour, just might make you debate, it's extremely important, so you address that. What is the individual external world? Those things. I have a wonderful one-liner. You can note it down on the first one. Your net worth is your network. In today's world of social and media, your net worth is not your money, but it's your network. Now, what does network and relationship mean? Not being in a backstabbing relationship and lose behavior. It's about dealing with a guy you don't like. You're thrown in a project, say you and this lady or this man, you do not get along well. How do you sink your differences and get to that objective which your boss or the organization is set? I think to me that's relationship. You know, your two students who accompanied me in the class are saying, so what does it take to really get off a bad start after MBA? The first thing is, how beautifully networked working relationship you have. Everybody's intelligent here. Standard deviation, plus minus 0.5 between the topper and the non-topper. Between the average, pretty much you guys are in a median. Balaji, entrance test, you're there, you've done the course. Yeah, there are some toppers here, some. But by and large, if a standard deviation match, then who succeeds? Two things. One, the guy who can smell change in advance and quickly do re-strategizing, re-architecting, so if I were to draw a bell curve, though bell curve is dead now, if I were to draw a bell curve 5 years from now, Bala sir say, hey, let me get this 2016-18 batch. So you got the 2015-17 batch, right? So if in 2022, I come here and I should have drawn a curve, who made it in this batch?
all other things being equal, God, luck, factor, all things apart, most probably the guys, the smart guys who will be able to smell a change and quickly readjust and quickly get into it. Go back to Mohinder Ramanath of India, the comeback man. I know most of you would not know him. His only trick was every time he went through a patch, he quickly readjusted his fight. I think people who will be adapting to change and ability will be really coming along. Then you look at this collective external policies, benefits, brand, etc. And most important, collective internal, which is all about cultural leader. What is Balaji's brand equity? By the way, how many of you did you read Economic Times? Yesterday's Economic Times? There's huge coverage on campus. Did you see that? Please, if you haven't, I request you go back. It will give amazing insight into what's happening, especially this batch and this batch. What's happening in the campus scenario? How are companies picking up people? What kind of job salaries? How are they getting interviewed? Beautiful full-length page article on Economic Times. Please go and pick it up, all right? I always tell people it doesn't matter if you don't brush your teeth, if you don't have a bath, but don't miss reading Economic Times every day. We're very important. Okay. So what's the premise? Invariably, most of you will start working for most companies which will be dealing with customers. And my question that I'm asking today is, what is the customer asking? I'm sorry, the customer is not asking, what can you do for me? He's instead asking, what else can you do for me? Like they say in Punjab, or about the key, right? What the heck is this else? And that's where you come in. You are that quintessential differentiator which else. How does Balaji's brand increase? This batch, 5 years from now, 80% of them do a smashing job. Better than they be ish or must chupai me chupai. Let the fragrance, you can make up when a man is in love, when a woman is in love. Ishq and mushk is fragrance. Let the fragrance, but how? By your sustained delivering value add in your respective job, and there are enough people in the market, business today, business world, who are capturing the sentiment at campuses, and there are enough publications on the net today saying, why is MIT up there at number one? Why is Howard up there? Within India context, why year on year, I don't know what comes up there. Can you get there? Is it pedagogy? Is it entrance, strictness of entrance test? Is this lack of politics in admissions? Is it pure meritocracy? I mean, there's a 2-3% dropout every year on ability, on inability to complete course. Very important. Therefore, I love what this man did and what he said. He's one of my role models. All right. And he's really saying, you can't keep asking companies, sir, bataiye na aapko kaise chahiye, main usse banke bataunga. You cannot keep asking the customer, because by the time you get the product ready, the customer has moved on in terms of his satiation and his appetite for his needs. All right? Okay. Let's come to the vector. Those of you who love some numbers here. Amazing stuff. I'm jealous of you because you've got this opportunity. Went back to some research. Please go through it very carefully. Number one, last year, 98,473 companies were registered. There are 4,400 startups. Employed close to 85,000, almost 100,000 employees. The 2014 investment was 2.2 billion. Oh my God, are you in a sweet spot, you bet. And those guys here in this room who are smelling of entrepreneurship, you've got an ecosystem which is really bad. Okay? 6.5 billion estimated 2015, 60 numbers a year to come in. Number of funds invested grew from 30% between 2013 and 14, that is from 330 to 436. The total value of venture capitalists and PE deals in 2014, 15.2 billion. Mostly consumers, so those of you who want to decide on your career path, look at where the sweet spots are, look at where the investments are going on. You know, it's consumer, technology, real estate, banking, financial services. Most startups in IT-enabled products and services in e-commerce, aggregators, Ola, Oyo. Ola is now wanting to do back integration with autos, and Pune is a great city for it. Imagine doing an auto through your Ola. Analytics, Internet of Things, health tech, and online payments. That's the kind of new wave. Two key issues, Mark. Sometimes early stage funding becomes an issue, angel and seed funding becomes an issue. And the other thing is, largely startups are in e-commerce and technology. So those guys who got the slot, leverage it. There's a lovely quote by Shakespeare. By the way, I wrote a blog on LinkedIn. Go and read it. It happened at 4:30 in the morning. I could not sleep that night. So I got up on your browsing television. And boom, breaking news. Microsoft buys out LinkedIn for $26.6 million. Oh my God, boom. $26.6 million. Of course, there's a joke the next day morning. Please stand up in 2 minutes of silence for all Microsoft employees who put up their job applications on LinkedIn. Because they need to know who's going to look out for the job. So, you know what happened? Around 5:30, I just sat mulling over this. What an acquisition. Immediately, a quote of Shakespeare came to my mind at 5:30 in the morning. There's a tide in the affairs of men. Literature students here, anybody in literature? There's a tide in the affairs of men which taken them leads on to fortune. Here was a company which just did this. And they sort of, sorry, this is not Microsoft, this was Yahoo being sold, taken over by Verizon. At one point in time, Yahoo was valued at $40 billion, guys. It got sold at $4.8 billion. It struck me, ye karmik hai, ye poor decision making. And it struck the Shakespeare's quote, there's a title in the Office of Men, which was not taken. And I quickly got on, by 6:30 I was done with the blog, I just wrote it there, and finally just seen the ending which I've done it. So, was it karmic? No. There are lots of graduates out there who do valuations, and somewhere they got it all wrong. No. You can do all the analysis. There is something jo kehte hain waqt se pehle muqaddar se zyada nahi milta. Right? So, it got sold at $4.8 billion. What is this disruption sale that's going on? Is what you want to really think about. Just very rough data for those of you who be interested in this. All right? I'm not going to read through it, but that's the space you operate under in terms of the opportunities that are there. Number of VC PE funds, 2014, right up there, right? We saw that 338, some 400 odd numbers. So great space for you all in terms of you architecting your future. Some examples of incubators and accelerators, I mean, they're all up there on the website, but I just thought I should quickly tell you what do they do and what do they do, but you can put it out from the Google so that I get more of interaction. So, This batch is soon going to start working. Please do one thing the day when you go. Tell your boss, what is my role? He's going to tell you, role, what role? You've rolled in now, right? You got a job. Just do what is given to you. Please be very alert and sensitive. A year will pass by, and then your boss will say, So get a clear thing. And that clear thing stems from this document, which is a corporate CEO document. Only three things CEOs want you to do. Make money, save money, or reduce the damn risk. You will be in one of these three roles. People in audit, people with finance background will probably do saving money and do reducing risk. Hotshot marketing guys will say quarter, uske baad mein, right? Right? And those guys will be out there. And please, don't even dream of marketing. First 10 years, chappal ghasito market to do sales. Get the damn sales in the market. Then talk of marketing, brand strategy, how you want to plan it up. So please, all you marketing guys, don't dream about. All right? Because invariably, I've seen in my campus interviews, it's a very famous experience which I've seen. So I'm sitting in the interview, the candidate walks in. Good morning. Sir, good morning. Good, come sit down. So, which specialization? Marketing. Marketing, yes. Good. Any particular topic? Now, when an interviewer asks you, you know what? Take out your gun from the hip and shoot that. It would be tragic if your interviewer asks you any one topic, he's giving you a signed blank check and you're not writing them out. I've seen students, push me. Come on, give me a lottery ticket, grab it. This is marketing product position, BCG. Fantastic. Here's the paper, here's the pen, show me BCG. The guy takes off. Tantadan. One square with four boxes. And crack star, he puts it. And I'm watching this guy. Then the guy's looking, yaha pe utar guy ka kaam kar raha hai. But basically, what is he done? यहाँ सारे हैं कुत्ता यहाँ गाय यहाँ पे बच्चा But if you understand the matrix and the two axes of market generated market growth, you get the fundas right. So it's very important when you go into an interview. 3 months from now, guys, 6 months maybe, you got to be this heartfelt wala and say, come, I'm ready. As I say in philosophy, when the pupil is ready, the master arrives. In 6 months now, jobs are going to come here. Are you ready for the game? Enjoy the battle. We'll talk about it. Okay. Very interesting, your generation. This is an Asia-Pac survey I picked up. 62% of APACs will shift in demographics. Look at that. 75% of global workforce will comprise of millennials by 2020, just 4 years from now. 75%. Look at the powerhouse of energy in India rocks. 70% of millennials want to launch their own businesses. I was doing a workshop for CEOs last month, and I told this guy, hey, you know what? Don't even bother about the top 2% population on performance. Don't bother about it. They determine their own competition, they determine their career path, and they're anyway leave. So don't be bogged down by attrition. These are guys hungry, and today the ecosystem is just providing that funding. So that goes on. And 58% of CEOs, people who are here to the front desk who are going to come and talk to you, are saying, Balaji campus gaya maan mila nahi bas. I, in my career, done about 15 years campus, both India and abroad. And it's very sad even for us when we go to campus and we come back without making an offer. We actually want there. We come here to make an offer. And then we go back in the room and say, I'm not getting that guy. We're going back. And the director says, ek mule, right? So when the opportunities are, I want to shine that. Because as I say in media, when the spotlight is on you, say, kyunki aapko spotlight kab milti nahi hai. And when it's on you, grab it. Therefore, do not come across as weak equipment. Another one, interesting one. 80% of CEOs believe technology will be the biggest. This is data. I know you know all this. But when it gets data, do you know what data, do you know what numbers do? Numbers, guys, gives a credibility and character to a conviction. What do you think? Is this yellowish brown or brownish yellow? No. I think it's 2080. Oh, wow. 2080, you just sort of gave a dimension. So one request to you. Every time now you look at those of you from arts background, liberal sciences, I know you do not have a natural slant for quantitative, but just get very number-driven, crunchy, absolutely, be quantitative. It gives you a little character and confidence to the whole thing. 86% of time in 2015 was spent on mobile apps, and 57% of world's mobile phone users are based out of APAC. Okay? That's the source of the survey. All right. Okay, quickly then. Very interesting. The war for talent is over and talent is won the war. So happy space for you. 92% of CEOs still believe grabbing the best guy. You know, it'd be very sad. There's a neighboring institute here in the same market area. It'd be very sad. A guy wants 5 marketing guys. He could not get 5. Picks up 2. The other 3 goes to a competition. Why? We just didn't drive to location. Wake up. Smell the coffee. Abhi walk. It's very important. Right? Nobody should be able to touch you and shake you on your concept of knowledge. We'll come to that in a bit of time. Okay, so what's your vector, guys? Are you playing not to lose? Are you playing a draw game? Which is sometimes very important in life, when your back is to the wall and you need to see the game. Or are you out there to say, come, bring it on? That is the spectrum in the two polarities. Okay? Playing not to lose is leading practices versus contextual adaptation leading practices. Piecemeal interventions versus holistic interventions. What is the topic of my topic here? Holistic success. I don't want you to be this amazingly wealthy guy, but down with hypertension, diabetes, and maybe some other relationship problems. Holistic success. All right? Focused on monitoring, that's the EVP. EVP stands for Employee Value Proposition, not Executive Vice President. All right? Knee-jerk reaction to every episode that comes in your life. Is there a knee-jerk reaction? And please go back, even as I'm talking, just go back to the last 10 episodes where you have to take a decision. Were you prepared? Were you a smart, awesomely prepared guy? Or was it when you're there with it? You might succeed once, but then you're going to be a genius of a guy to succeed every time without preparation. And lastly, owned by silos, owned by business. So what's your vector is what you need to decide, what you want to play the game for. Finally, the architect, as I said, I'm going to make it very crisp and I want to really take it on a more interaction basis. So negotiating the road ahead, that's from Lonavala here, which we were just now coming from, Bombay to Pune, all right? Barriers to startups. If some of you, startups is a big thing now, right, from Prime Minister down to Mr. Amitabh Kant, Niti Aayog executive, oh my God, you guys in a happy space. And there's some amazing stories about entrepreneurship. There's one, I must share this, and please help me, if any of the profs can help me recall, there's one alumnus of yours in Pune, and he gave me his card, and he is into an amazing business. There's a lot of public toilets, people do not use it. He's got into that business of cleaning up entrepreneurship, his own ideas, all right? When you read this book called Good to Great, you must, all of you read this book, seminal book for business students called Good to Great by Jim Collins. And he's really saying, very important thing is, get the right people in the bus. Some of you, in 2 years from now, will be offloaded of the bus for the company if there is consistent lack of performance. So don't get jolted, avoid it. So let me give you an example. I used to play golf, I still sometimes play. I read somewhere in this research, can you believe it? Tiger Woods scored a horrible 78 rank on a concept called clearing the sand pit. Because when a ball goes in the sand, you need to clear it. And apparently Tiger Woods was not very good at it. He was otherwise a great champion. Any guesses what his coach is busy doing, working on? Any coach? His coach is not working on saying, how do you clear the sand pit? He's telling him, sand pit for avoiding. So avoid areas where you're weak. Or you ratchet up your strengths, right? Why I'm talking this is, do not give anybody an opportunity for you to be offloaded. And most important is getting the right people in the right seats. Even when you're a right guy, imagine if you're a finance guy, you're given an admin role. You're this HR person who's given a finance role. There are some companies have a general management pool, and then you're all at sea, okay? All right. So the key question is, do you have the right bus to carry the right people? My belief is Balaji has the right people. I hope and pray for all of you to let the right bus come here. 3-4 months now, and this group here, 4 months from now, you'll be entering summer internship. Very, very important. You know, that's your first, unless you had an earlier work experience, this batch, that's your first online, real-time experience to talk about next year in the interview. So make a killer of a summer intern. Do an awesome project. Let it be a business manager's executive summary to success. Do not take your summer intern as picnic. It could well be the base which can decide your vector in an exchange. In fact, I got 2-3 placement offers at my campus purely on the basis of a summer project. Okay. So then, how do you solve the trichotomy? What's the three trichotomy that you guys are going to get into it? There's this huge financial appetite, the finance function, technology, the tsunami that's coming in, and most important, the human capital. This is the human capital. But that intersection there is where companies make a mess of. Some companies are completely financial. Ropla, paisa. Right? Some companies, they get the high of only if technology, even when it's not required, they'll get a technology. Right? And some companies are so people-oriented that the business does not sustain. Some of the companies, you know what happens. You know, they don't care, and companies and people are laid off. Okay, so what's your task, ladies and gentlemen? My humble suggestion is coming from my experience. I think these are the things you need to battle with and put it into wonderful jigsaw puzzles. Look at those words out there. There are a lot of action items out there. I think your task is to get this into a fantastic square diagram. Whether it's commitment to the vision, to trust, to influence the outcome, to performance focus, to any which of the business actors and leading teams. You know, Dara and Rishabh, you both were in the car and you were asking yourself, what does it take to A, get off to a great start at corporate and then have a sustainable success? Getting this combo is extremely strong. And do not make a mistake here. So that's the wonderful line I'm reminded of. Joshua Hawass mein kya hai ki galti kar baitha. Joshua Hawass mein kya hai ki galti kar baitha. Tamam umr manzil mujhe dhoondh liye. Which means what? People are chasing goals. You're so bloody lucky, the goal is chasing you. Ab dud ko ke nashe ho gaye kisi gali mein pade ho. Symbolically speaking.
masti mein, don't care, reckless. It's extremely important for you to remain focused. I was telling them, focus, focus, focus. Extremely. I know you know all this, though. I don't want to be preachy about this. In fact, a lot of you are already shining examples of all this. I can bet you on that. Okay, so up close and professional then, all right? So I take off today afternoon, tomorrow I'm going to Jaipur. Can I take off in a Boeing, in a smaller aeroplane, and by the time I reach Jaipur, can I re-architect the plane into a swashbuckling Boeing 747? You say, Pramod, are you a drug or you're drunk? How can that happen? Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. Welcome to your arena, which is called Transforming While Performing. This is exactly what you need to do. You take off an ambassador from Pune, by the time you hit Bombay, Mumbai, are you able to convert it to a swashbuckling BIMHRD 7? Conceptually, not possible, but people have done that. And then we'll talk about examples a little later. Okay, so then, it's about building transformation over time. I'm going to skip because we want to chat up. Whatever comes next, and most important, we are in the information age and you've never left it. In fact, your arena is going to be data, data, data. So when I throw an Excel spreadsheet, campus interviews, this is going to throw an Excel spreadsheet, they'll throw an RPA report at you. Can you give an executive summary in the next 10 minutes? We'll go for a cup of tea and come back. Do you hire all your finance biscuits? Can you sort of know exactly where to hit it? Which are the quick ratios? Which are the critical ratios to determine success of a company? And when he comes back, see, here are the five ratios. Boom, they're boom. Quick on the go, shooting from the hip, quick on the draw. Speed, it's all about speed. Therefore, what are the key terms? Please connect experience anywhere to anywhere. 20 years back, people in Bombay, in Madras, Delhi, Calcutta had an edge. Today, a girl from Madras, we hired her to take me. Risha Pula's got a top CA examination. Any CAs here? Okay, and I'm sure some of you have attended CAs, right? You know what it is? It's hell, right? There's a guy from Mirzapur who cracked an IIT entrance. So, the technology is completely ensured. Security is extremely important. I mean, if this guy gets lost, this organ, the 79 organ, I mean, I'm almost suicidal, in a manner of speaking. My life comes to a halt, because everything is packed into this, all right? And then, sharing and collaboration. I was telling you, your relationship quotient is very important these days. Ladies and gentlemen, some of you will not make it in life, and I hope nobody falls in that bucket. It will not be because they're not hardworking and intelligent. You're just so poor at relationships. Everybody hates you. You master the art of irritating everybody, right? And therefore, success gravitates. It attracts. Throw a few cubicles of sugar here, ants will come from you don't know where. The moment you have this amazing role model, profile, helping, genius, hardworking, people will gravitate. Try and become that. That's what will get you success out there. Democratizing information, we talked about it. There is no edge for bringing to an elitist school or a club membership. It's all about what value you bring to the table. You know all this. Spanning premise, okay, we'll skip this. Okay, so it's about new possibilities. All right? I don't know, running fast, but most importantly, welcome to the new era, and I'm right in the center of it. In fact, Jaipur, I'm doing a trip to compete for a bid, and my four competitors are there. So the client who's called four of us, saying, show me what you have, and why should we give the business to you? Gun on the head, business at its best, all right? And that is about just going from on-premise to cloud, all right? And it's all about cloud and digital technology. Lucky you, most people here are very savvy people in this room, I know that. The way you manage your profiles and the n number of messages and amazing data on LinkedIn and what have you, oh my God, there is a, as I said, tsunami of information coming. How to sift it and quickly take your position is extremely important. Okay? So it's about building a bridge. Okay? Transformation. Any which aspect of your life is all about transformation. And how do you transform? This is Burj Khalifa when it was raw, and look what has gone on to become today a swashbuckling symbol of engineering excellence. Are you into that transformation? Ladies and gentlemen, this batch, New Year's, please grab There are so many unlucky people not in this room. Grab this opportunity and transform yourself. Balaji will be very proud, if not your parents, right? You'll be very proud if you transform yourself. And that's the, if you've seen a video of a caterpillar changing to a butterfly, there is pain, there's blood, there's bones creaking, there's white blood, all symbolic of your pain. But the beautiful butterfly, actual butterfly, is actually appreciated by everybody, right? So therefore, but there are problems. And let me give you some consolation. Every morning I walk into the office, these three demons come and sit on my shoulders. After 25 years experience, I'm still a victim of this. Ek hota hai, aap hai mujhe maan. Dusra hota hai, yaar bail kadar bata na, main jaana chahta hoon. I had a very crux of my presentation. My pity and sympathy for guys who become victims of the three demons. It will kill you. It will paralyze you. When you're in the middle of your career, they are fear. I really think that Gabbar Dara was very important. Your guide us from others. Number two, if you want to poison your will, don't go and buy phenyl. Just put a doubt and your will is poisoned and you can go to hell. And last is brooding worry. This college might teach you this, might not teach you this. They're definitely teaching you internal rate of return. They're definitely teaching you product portfolio positioning. They're definitely teaching you master hierarchy. They're teaching you net present value. This is not taught at Howard Business School, quote unquote. This largely comes, hopefully, through your parents, the way your parents have brought you up. But this is your time. Like this Harry Potter author, what's her name? So she says, read a beautiful article on Wikipedia. Go and check out an article called The Importance of Imagination and Fringe Benefits of Failure. It's a speech she gave at Howard graduation ceremony about 4 years back. And she says that in American context, the day you take to the wheels, you lose your right to blame anybody for any of your failures. Wow. You got your license? You're an adult. You arrived now. You announced your arrival. Bus. Ab kisi ko blame karna khatam. It's gone. Please go for your parents. So after 10 years of service, your appraisal report comes. You're technically brilliant, you know, but short up or okay? So my grandfather's size. Oh, ninja. You can't do that. You've got to own it up, take the bull by the horns. Okay? And therefore, three critical factors. Of course, evaluating 10 spreadsheets in 2 hours. It needs huge, huge IQ. And I hope all of you are blessed with amazing CPU. I was telling somebody 1 year, a few years, I used to be in this interview panel from an industry perspective at the IIM entrance examinations. And I remember those days there were 7 IIMs and there were 200 people each intake. So 1,400 students were sandwiched. I will use the, not use the word sandwich, I'll use the word shoved. 1,400 students were shoved in a percentile score of 99.7600. How brutal is that? And of course, there are people who cracked. So that's how brutal it is. You've got to be very savvy. You know what not to say, you know what to say. Because in today's world, everything is being captured, your privacy is lost. Let me tell you, I'm giving to give some of you my phone number, you take my card. Just call me, okay, today? Just call me. And guess what's happening tomorrow? In your Facebook page, my photo will be there, and we want to invite him as a friend. And in my Facebook page, your photo. Who's grabbing all this? Boy, there is somebody who's supervising you. Your data is not secure. Hey, listen, any major way, on a Twitter, the moment you go public, you cannot fight for intellectual property rights. Say, no, you cannot distribute. God, it's all of a thing. So better be careful what you post. In one of the companies, we had to sack a guy because he applied for sick leave saying that my mother is sick and this and that and blah, blah, blah. And we gave him leave amidst a very critical project. The bro was stupid enough next morning to say, hey, dude, I'm rocking in Goa Beach with a beer in the hand. All right? No press for guessing what happened to him. Because there's nothing which is private today. Listen, if you apply to me, even with the baat ki baat hai, I first go to Google, Facebook, LinkedIn. Within 3 vehicles, I've mapped 60% of you. Yes or no?
Yes.
Uske baad, 3 calls to 3 employers. Boy, when you walk into the interview, I mapped you 90%. The only thing that happens is chemistry jumped back. That's so much data is up there in cloud. So be careful. And lastly, of course, I want to talk about this because a lot of you get trapped
into shady deals. Be very careful, especially people in finance. You'll sign papers, so we'll talk about that, okay? My success score is this. Currently, my research topic for my PhD is this. Your personal quotient, ladies and gentlemen, is a function of course, IQ. You need great IQ. You need a great EQ, but the multiplier is SQ. Simple arithmetic, IQ 120, EQ 120. Kitna ho gaya? 240. 240 into 0 is 480, right?
0.
480, yaar?
0.
Exactly. So you screw up on that last one, sab kiya karaya economic time front paper, boom, gone. Cotton is scam, sexual harassment, illegal dealings. Do not fall into any of this. In tennis, there is a term called, what's that called? Voluntary and involuntary, right? Forced and unforced error, right? Please be very careful of getting into forced error business. Unforced is your weakness. But be very careful, they're very important these days, because so then, re-architecting yourself is get physically energized. If you think Balaji and Sir is giving you 18 hours of work, wait till you meet your first boss. Weekends gone, sometimes. So get ready for the battle, enjoy it actually, okay? You gotta be mentally focused. As I said, you get 30 minutes to make a quick analysis or lead in something, especially in the first 2-3 years. You gotta be emotionally charged. I was telling my 2 students who accompanied me, this is my hour and my space. Nothing bothers about Jaipur presentation. After this, I'll go back and do my work again. Working on it till 3 last night. Therefore, if you see a bit of puff guys, or I'm not looking fresh, that's because there is some awesome data crunching to be done on 14 slides. It had to be done yesterday, right? Temperature or no temperature, right? So therefore, it's important for you to be charged. Hey, I will believe one thing, when a doctor sees a pulse, if any one of you, and this is an interesting question, even Abhibhi Bhakta, even now, if anybody can place a finger on the pulse of your life, the purpose for which you are, maybe you want to be a great guitarist, not another financial analyst. Maybe you want to be a great drummer. Maybe you want to be something else. Even now there is time. Next, probably 3 years. Get hold of that guy. Sachin found out his batting career. BIMHRD Joshi said, I'm born for singing. I'm a superlative. And you know what? Just stick to the knitting and intense hard work of asking the company guys. You see the magic that's going to happen. Please, can I request you, do not be a victim of peer pressure. She may be great at this, but do not copy her because she's your friend. The companies you apply for, don't bother. You know what's going to happen day one? You apply for companies you're not cut out for, at 7:30 that night, you're almost about to commit suicide. Because you got rejected on all the campuses. You know? You don't want to be in that. Chill. You're not for day one companies, you're not the McKinsey type, you're the FMCG type, and take help of amazing mentors here and professors and get to it because it's one precious time, right? You don't want to screw it up. And most importantly, and I keep saying this, by the way, I'm not from Asta channel or I just want to tell you this, that I'm almost learning you now. The heart of any problem, whether it's an engine carburetor or whatever it is actually the problem of the heart. इसको ना नौकरी में एक वर्ड है बंदे के बाद जिगरा है जिगरा इफ यू डू नॉट हैव जिगरा किस गुड बाय टू कॉर्पोरेट क्रेडिट दैट श्योर एनर्जी एंड सेइंग आई विल फाइट व्हेदर इट्स लॉन्ग आवर्स और स्टैंडिंग अप एंड सेइंग थिंक दिस वंस सो आई डू नॉट एग्री विद दिस प्राइसिंग स्ट्रेटजी इन सौराष्ट्र मार्केट इट वोंट फ्लाई एंड योर बॉस वाज राइट या आई हैव अ प्रीवियस एक्सपीरियंस आई लव हिज कॉन्फिडेंस बॉडी इन बैक ऑफ द कॉन्फिडेंस विद डेटा Push it on, bring it on. Hey, it's your space. Do what you feel like. It's important. And be very honest to your conviction. Do not get bogged down by peer pressure or trends in the air today. There's a purpose for which you're born. And just ensure that you're out there. And therefore, I would like you to go and visit this site. I have benefited immensely. There's a lot of mindfulness, but I think you want to really go and check out this, what's going on there. It's important for the last thing called SQ, spiritual quotient. All right? Just do it. Do what? What? Meditate. Sir, I'm Balaji ke students, sir. Marketing ke guru, sir. Kya meditation is sikha raha. And the next slide will blow your mind of why I'm saying this. First time probably getting ready to preach. First time. And very consciously so. You know why? The
emotional upheaval you will go through in your corporate career. If this guy is, you know, imagine you're there, you're shaking like this at the time taking decisions. Whether it's a stock purchase or investment, your actual molecule here is wobbling. Solid! Which will this guy be completely relaxed. You cannot take a smart decision for all your 99% GMAT score if you are not in control. So you know why I'm telling you to do? Not because I wanted to become moms. Not because I wanted to become this sanspan, you know, all this stuff. Because, check out this. Why do you meditate? Check out this guy. He was thinking, when he said, why meditate, sir, tell us about Niyom, Niyom, Uliyom, and all that. No, I've got some other angle here, guys. India scores a horrible rank on ease of doing business and transparency, international corruption, perception, global index. India is 83. So I'm making a very strong assertion here. This to me is a future leadership of the country. If anybody here is screwed up in his value systems, trust me, for all the opportunity they are there, we will not make it. We will not make it. It's important for you to really rise up as an awesomely centered individual, solid. Nothing, no negative factors will shake you off. And that's where I'm saying, forget becoming spiritually very succinct and very nice. But I think this is the reason why you need to be involved, because you guys are going to deal with crores and billions of money and decisions. All right? Okay, so it's your time. Can't play the video, I tried. So it's your time. And therefore, a great hockey player, he said, a good hockey player, this is ice hockey, not the regular hockey. A good hockey player plays where the puck is. A great hockey player plays where the puck is gonna be. Are you that guy whose ability to anticipate change, adjust, do the course correction, and go for that? And that's where it is. So therefore, focus, guys, what matters most. And I love this. I mean, what are you going to do? Some 30% turnover? Yeah. It's a new expansion, hiring 100 people, big deal. But there's 53% in Jaisalmer, or 53 degrees in Jaisalmer, or minus 25 station. You and I sleep well because they are there. And the reason I picked up this beautiful picture is inner commitment. There's material pressure, there is people saying, your parents' pressure, what about this internal? Just drive this internal guy, he's sitting up there, dormant. Just unwrap it from fear, doubt, worry, unwrap the bandage. And just go out there saying, it's my commitment. And that's commitment. You know, with the 53 Jaisalmer or minus 21 creation, you and I speak with somebody out there, he's really protecting people who are out to eat all our boundaries, right from, you know what I mean, EUK and Tibet and everything. So with that, I just want to thank you. My purpose here was, as I said, to lend a perspective, to obviously to motivate you. It is to inspire, and you can do it. It is not to showcase a lot of Google data. It was not to preach about my company. As you said, there's not a single slide in article. But that's not the intention here. The intention is to infuse and transmit energy. And if that can happen, imagine what a vector you would have defined energy. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. I will leave some time. I want some questions to come in, and then we can do the applause. All right? And it's very important for you to remember one last beautiful Sufi couplet. It's my favorite. I said it last year. I'm going to repeat. Par par kitaba ilm da tu naam rakh liya, kaz hath vich talwara phad ke tu naam rakh liya, ghazi king ghazan plundered thee. But the corner of his word power, kill me. Hath vich talwara phad ke tu naam rakh liya ghazi, Makkah Madina hoon aaya, tu naam rakh liya haji. So par par kitaba ilm da tu naam rakh liya ghazi, Hapis Talwara Farki tu naam rakh liya Gandhi, Makkah Madina Ghumaya tu naam rakh liya Haji. O bande, tu ki hasil kita, je yaar na rakhe razi. Friends, this yaar, first of all, is Rab, God. Second, your parents. What the heck if you didn't keep them happy? Third, if you're an employer, your employees are your yaar. In this batch, your yard are the batchmates. When you start employing somebody under you, they are your yard. So basically, your entire 360 degree, if you are not able to get them, your network is zero. Because there's no network based on authenticity. So ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. I hope I made sense. on a very grounded basis, very realistic, down-to-earth, authentic basis, so that you've got, even if one guy here or girl has been nudged, there's a book called Nudge, please read it, I don't remember the author, N-U-D-G-E, Nudge. My effort here was to nudge, not to show off my mastery or my company's prowess at the Oracle technology. It's about nudging you. You need that nudge. Hopefully, even if one of the guys in this room or the ladies has got nudged to say, I'm going to travel, not to the next increment level, but the next orbit, I think this is a really great session. We'll open it up for Q&A now. I'd love to have more questions, and then we'll take it from there. Anything which is bugging on us, there are no stupid questions, so don't feel shy. But all the question which is in your mind is from somebody else's mind.
Good afternoon, sir.
Hi.
I am Ayushka Grewal,
yes,
pursuing PM and HR as my course, junior batch. My question to you is, like you said, ki avoid your areas in which you are weak. Sir, but what if these weak areas are mandatory to be performed in the organization then?
Okay, her actual question is, so what if I'm studying a subject which I don't like at Balaji? Just kidding. Okay, when you get on a job, I'm going to be very practical here. You're there for a career and money. A lot of things we'll have to do which you'll not like. And that's where I would call psychological maturity rises up and you says, I'm going to go through this. I'm going to go through the drudgery of this and I will make it. So this is where, when people say, oh, he's a very humble guy. What does humble humility mean? Humility is saying, yes, I'm this God-gifted man guy in marketing, but right now I have to arrange an administration called transport for a board meeting. And your boss says, what's your name, Neha?
Arushi,
fix seamless, problem-free hotel accommodation for the board meeting and transport. Sir, my Balaji ke MBU, sir. Do it. That's why I'm going to test you saying, do you have to do, as I say, roll up the sleeves and take it on and do sometimes what you do it. Do it for a short while. But if that becomes a permanent thing, you need to change your character. You need to talk to your boss, sir. I respect this. I've even done it. Do it first. Earn your stripes, as I say in army. Fiti come up early. Earn your stars and stripes. I've done it, sir. But sir, frankly, this is not my domain, sir. I would request you for a pass. Nicely, but deliver first. So guys, no, yeah, she delivers, man. I mean, yeah, so good for her. She likes something else, so I must respect that. And it's a good organization. They're a great multinational, some of which I've worked for. They'll accommodate such a thing. But you've got to make an awesome business case, but first through delivery and valuation. You cannot go like a king and say, I'm not here for this. Not in the first place. So take it as a learning curve. Sometimes learning curve is not gradient, it's a steep learning curve. Short time, but steep. But you need to. Have I answered your question?
Yes, sir.
All right. Anything else?
No, really, as sir. We are running out of time,
yes.
So this will be the last question.
Thank you. A very good afternoon, sir. My name is Sumit Saxena from BIMHRD Marketing. So we are talking about three devils that a person or any organization face: fear, doubt, and worry.
Yeah.
So on this, I wanted to know that how can we tackle it? Because for human beings, anything that is challenging would create fear, would create a doubt, and there would be worry. So are there any techniques or skills or something that we as managers can apply on?
Right. So I'm not some spiritual coach here telling you, don't worry, Balak, what's nothing of that sort. You're very right. Even I told you, after 25 years, I walk into my office every day with three demos coming sitting here. After 25 years, with all the coaching that I do, it's a reality. But not to be intimidated. Because the moment, okay, Hindi mein dialogue, ek machar aadmi ko, that fear, once it sets in, boy, you get grounded before you take it. So how do you do it? Number one, I'll give a behavioral response and I'll give a systemic response. Systemic response, solid preparation. You know why I hate people who score very well in academics? There's a discussion. Sir, MBA career in academics is important. My first question is, you pay math any answer. But my boss wanted it. One thing when somebody says 80%, 10th, 85, 12, I'm not saying people score 60 or bad. What it gives me is, this guy is a academic. Is dependable. 80, 85, 90, matlab, is guy consistency hai yaar, kuch ho bhi jaye, this guy rocks. This guy is a method, a discipline. And I can bank upon this, he will not let me down. So it gives that confidence. So number one, awesome, solid, rock solid confidence. And you'll not be excused for it, and nobody can snatch away from it. Can I?
working hard at 2 in the morning. Just go and grab it. Abhyas and accounting. Number two, this is systemic. The behavioral part is largely your parent and your religious beliefs sometimes come in very handy. And it's not over here. It's all over the world. Every one of us has a God or a religious or whatever it is where we derive our source of strength. It's actually all here. Right? There's a book called Your Soul's Journey, and it says, heart is actually the seat of the soul. Heart, the where the soul sits. You need to drive from immense reservoirs of energy from internally and from your ecosystem. Parents, friends, role models, professors. There's some great people here. Bala sir is an amazing, and they're not praising him because I'm here. I've known him for 20 years how he's built this up. Resilience, he doesn't know fear. Hard work. At this stage, he's still at it. You've got an awesome role model right here. Just grab those qualities. One of the best things is, nobody can stop you from robbing good qualities from others. I can stop you from robbing myself, but I cannot stop you. There's no patent there. So dip into the deep reservoirs of spiritual energy. Parents, friends, brothers, sisters, role models. It's very handy, boss. And as Amerikan says, Ali is there.
Okay? Thank you.
Very important.
Thank you.
Last one. So that is on fear, right? Worry is actually an interest you're paying for the money you're not even going to come back, right? It is of no value, okay? Doubt, why the doubt? As I said, you want to poison your will, which is what we all love to run through with. How can you crack an interview if you don't have willpower? On the day basis, I'm going to do my best. I'm not saying I'm going to get the job. I will put up this interview script saying, what a bloody awesome guy I met today in the interview. I'll come here with going like that. There's a girl many years and I remember, she was a marketing guru. And I gave her a very tough question. She was expert on 4 P's, right? And now 6 P's. So I was trying to drill her concept 20 was practical example. So I just told her, okay, 190 people in the batch. You want to pick up your life partner. Can you apply? Courtless 4P marketing principle. Boy, oh boy, the way she sort of really analyzed the whole thing. The data, the batch, who's the product? Is she the product or the guy the product? Right? Awesome! It was not a Colgate Palmolive example, not a Pepsi. It was something in the realm of relationship. If you want to pick up your future life partner for 190 batch, is there a science or a principle of what you can apply? Boom! And one thing be prepared, while you're good at academics, quickly back it up with a solid concrete example to validate that concept. So very simple, deep. There's a saying in English, long hours with God, whatever the concept of God, build deep reservoirs of energy in crisis. You can't call it on demand. Sorry, courage won't come on demand with your credit card. You've got to do it right from now. Here, now. And episode after episode, episode over a period of time, when such an incident centuries, I think I can take on Basima. You just played that, right? It's very important for you to be at it here, now, and forever. Okay? I hope I've given you a framework. I respect that there's a time constraint. But guys, thanks a lot. Always a great joy coming to Balaji.
Volatility, unpredictability, complexity, ambiguity, the various disruptions caused by VUCA. And so, you should keep in mind the thought which you shared with us. Your network is your network. Thank you so much, sir.
May I now request Dr. K.K. Villori, Director BITM, to present a token of appreciation to Mr. Pramod Sadarjoshi.